Wakanda forever!
Play, come out to play, come out to play.
We'll all have a
really nice day, really nice day, really nice day.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and team and all ages, or whatever ages, just saying. Today, I'm going to play out for you guys. Today, I'm going to do a rant on the worst movie of 2006. If you want to watch a way better 2006 movie, just go watch Cars. Cars is way better than this movie, so. Alright, hello guys, this is your pal Nikki2001 here. And today, I'm going to do a movie rant. It's going to be a simple rant. I don't feel like doing extreme rant, because extreme rant is pretty overrated now. Thanks for N1000001. Thank it's extreme rant is better than God's. Oh, please. And so, today, I'm going to do a simple rant on Disney the Wild. Came out to you from 2006. The only movie I know from 2006. Is Cars, so I don't know every movie, but I'm not gonna waste my time talking about all the movie came out, so I don't want to talk about it. So, alright, so guys, let's get to plot, shall we? Basically, the plot is about the lion trying to war, and everyone don't like him, and so his father was not happy, and so the lion got kidnapped, and so his father team up with the giraffe, squirrel, and him, and they team up. And find his son and defeat the villain and defeat the god awful villain, and that's basically the plot is. Sorry, based upon one, because it's been a while I watched this movie and I don't care about the plot because that plot is an absolute rip off to The Lion King and Finding Nemo. And I'm probably Freeman will kinda agree with me, so I need an actual opinion about this movie. So if you like this movie, I respect your opinion. But for me, I am not a fan of this movie. And no joke, I used to love this movie. I used to love this movie back in 2006. As a matter of fact, I used to buy this movie on DVDs. And thank God I watched it because I don't want to think about that movie. And if I see that DVD, I am not going to buy it. I'm not going to burn it. I'm just gonna annoy it and go away. Like a mature kid. Well, I'm not a kid, but I'm a teenager. So yeah, whatever. And so I watched this movie on Disney Plus. What did I think of it? This movie is a piece of monkey poop. This movie is a piece of lion poop. This movie is a piece of monkey poop. Did they take a monkey poop and put him in the poster and you made this movie? Sorry guys, I'm not taking this movie way too seriously. It's just a joke. And so, are there any positives with this movie? I got one positive. The one positive is they play Coldplay, Crocs on, and that billboard scene when the lion crying and the scene. That's it. That's completely it. The rest of the movie, oh man, let's buckle up your seatbelt and get ready for rant. With no waging, just a rant, but I don't feel like doing extreme rant waging for 24 hours, but it's going to be pretty overrated. And so, let's get the story. This story is the absolute rip-off to The Lion King and Finding Nemo. It's kind of remind me of the Edo Studios, not Disney. It's kind of remind me that Edo Studio watched The Lion King back in And I forgot the meal call. I'm not gonna actually, so I'm stupid. So it's feel like. So this movie is absolutely rip-off to The Lion King and Finding Nemo. It kind of feel like the Edo Studio is not from Disney. It's from the Edo Studio. They watch Lion King. They watch Finding Nemo. And I'm wondering, they're probably gonna say, you know what? Let's take The Lion King and Finding Nemo and put it in this movie. Green light. Okay, studio. Okay, would you stop making rip-off movie? And I'm probably Pixar will sue you because Finding Nemo is one of the best movies from 2003, and The Lion King is one of the greatest movie, of the Disney Renaissance. This was, I don't have any wars Disney Renaissance movie. I really enjoy the hookery, but okay, off topic. So studio, would you stop making rip-off movie because rip-off movie is freaking ridiculous? Okay. Okay, I just saying the mature, so yeah. And so the story is the Lion King and Finding Nemo done bad. And seriously, this is Finding Nemo and the Lion King done bad. Done bad, because those movies are great, and this movie is a piece of monkey poop. So yeah, the story is absolutely stupid. It's absolutely whip off too, and I don't want to talk about it. And so, let's get to animation. Animation, oh my goodness. This is one of the worst animation I have ever seen in a Disney movie. No joke. This movie, this animation, it is out of the worst animation I have ever seen in my life. And I know I give a credit for the animation, but this animation, it looked disgusting. Look at this. It looked like CGI. Oh my goodness. Why people want to play this animation? It looked disgusting. So yeah, no joke, this movie, Madagascar came out 2005. This is Madagascar done bad. I forgot to say it, because this movie is Madagascar done bad. So, my goodness, would you stop making rip-off movie? You rip off Finding Nemo, you rip off of The Lion King, and now you rip off Madagascar. No, not the second one. I'm talking about the first movie. It came out 2005. So Madagascar came first, and this movie came second. That's stupid. Wish this movie don't exist. But I'm not gonna rage, but I'm just doing this for a joke. Let's get to character, shall we? His father, he's stupid. So stupid. Next. And let me see, the koala. Well, who agreed with me, a koala from scene is way better than this. Even I don't like scene because that movie is out of the worst December 2016 movie of 2016. And the squirrel, he's forgettable. Giraffe, lame. And alligator, people forgot that character, but I do, it's in the poster, so he's forgettable. And the snake, he's not in the poster, he's annoying. So yeah, it is colorful with the squirrel and the giraffe. What's in studio? That is absolutely stupid. Who on earth wanna fall in love with the squirrel? Hey, you know what? You wanna see way better colorful? Hey, just go see Christoph X Anna. Christoph X Anna is way better than that. Way better than the squirrel X giraffe. You can't fall in love with the giraffe. And you can't fall in love with the squirrel. Animal X animal. Past. Oh my goodness. Let's get the villain. That villain is even worse than Hans for Frozen. That's right. The villain is, oh my goodness, this is out of the worst Disney villain. I forgot the villain call, so I'm gonna call him a villain. So that villain is out of the second worst Disney villain I ever seen in my life. The worst Disney villain I ever seen in my life, other than Hans for Frozen, my favorite franchise of all time. Don't want to talk about that guy. I wouldn't want to do a rant on that guy, but I don't do character rants, so character rant is pretty outdated. And so, the opening scene of the Wago, I'm never a fan of it. It's pretty annoying, and I want to say, oh my god, get on with it. Oh yeah, let's get the worst thing about this movie. It's not a song called Having a Nice Day. That song is atrocious. Having a Nice Day. I agree with a lot of people. This has got to be the worst Disney song I have ever seen in my life. Do you want to see way better Disney song? Go listen Show Yourself. Just go listen Into the Unknown. Those songs are way better than Having a Nice Day. And the lyric, oh my goodness, it's really annoying as heck. And if you don't want to see me sing, I'm probably recommend you skip that part. So I'm just going to sing. I have a very nice day, very nice day. Oh, having a very nice day. More like, I having the worst day I have ever stood in my life. I hate this movie so much because I hate it. I hate it. I wish this movie don't exist in the first place. And I'm raging, so back what I was saying. So yeah, I have nothing to say about this movie. The Wire is that one of the worst movies from 2006, and Cars is way better than this. But my opinion on Cars is really to claim, because my thought on Cars is pretty mediocre movie, so. So if you enjoy Cars, I respect opinion. But for me, it's pretty mediocre, so. So yeah, I don't want to get started talking about Cars 2. Oh man, I don't want to talk about that movie. I used to love The Wire, but now I hate it. And this movie is even worse. This movie is even worse than Chicken Little, Home in the Range, Mosby Mom, and especially Artemis Fowl. Oh, one question. Is this my worst Disney film of all time? No, the worst Disney movie I ever seen in my life is another day, Artemis Fowl. I'm not talking about Artemis Turd, but I don't want to make a fun of that in the movie. Even I hate the movie, but I respect opinion. But the people out there like Artemis Fowl, I respect opinion. But for me, I am never fanning up this movie because that movie is a piece of monkey poop. And so, I'm gonna give this awful movie a 0 out of 10. This is completely bullcrap. Just don't watch it and board it like a play. You wanna see? Hey guys, you wanna see way better Disney movie? Hey guys, you wanna see way better Disney movie? Disney movie? Just go watch Bolt. Just go watch The Princess and the Frog. Even I call this movie overrated, but I kind of enjoy it, but it's pretty mediocre. Just go watch Tangle. Just go watch Winnie and the Pooh. I haven't seen the movie, but it's pretty babyish, so I'm not going to watch it. And mind if I just go watch Wreck-It Ralph, Skip, and Frozen, Big Hero 6, Zootopia, Moana, Wild Play Internet, and Mother Fact. I hire you where to watch Frozen 2. Even you don't like Frozen 2, but those Disney movies are way better than this piece of garbage. But in the future, can I show this movie to my kid? Heck no, I'm not gonna show this movie to my kid. I'm gonna show this movie to my kid. It's Frozen 2. So even if it's two little girls, but I will show them Frozen 2 and The Lion King. Those movies way better than this movie. I'm done waiting this movie. Oh man, I am so sweaty because all that rant. Alright, so guys, that was my movie rant on The Wire. I'm not gonna say unhappy anniversary because I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna say it because that thing is pretty hot west, so I don't know why I said that. No woman North Extreme Man, so I was planning to go in to redo my No Woman North Extreme Man, so that rant is stupid. So that rant is absolutely stupid. So, alright, so guys, what about a Frozen 2 rookie trailer style? Well, what kind of surfer trailer came out like that crap? Hold on a minute. I'm part of that one trailer came up with F9. It's called Fast and Furious 9. That trailer is absolutely fantastic. And if I make a Frozen 2 trailer style event, people will hate it because it's the Frozen haters. So yeah, I respect their opinion if you don't like Frozen 2. But I really want to do a Fast and the Furious 9 trailer style of Frozen 2. But I'm probably Frozen would get pissed off. He'd rather see Rookie flavor in that, so I will make that in the future. So my Frozen 2 Rookie Trailer style is the way tomorrow, because I really want to do a commentary on the hookery from Infowl being 2001, so I don't want to think about that, so I'm going to do a commentary on that. It's going to be my first commentary video, so stay tuned for that. Ding, ding, ding. And so, I got a lot of plans to do a video today. Alright guys, if you like this kind of content, hit the subscribe button, turn notification, and comment below, and let me know, and stay tuned for my more Family Guy Toon style, and I really enjoy, I hope you really enjoy my Family Guy Toon style. Here's that one YouTuber don't like Family Guy, he keep bashing my opinion of it, so I don't know why, so Family Guy is one of my favorite adult cartoon of all time, so yeah. Well, I'm probably Rick and Morty is fantastic too, but I want to go Family Guy more than the Rick and Morty, so yeah. And so, stay tuned for my Family Guy, more Family Guy Toon style. Request me any Family Guy scene you want me to do. Stay tuned for my, I think my next extreme rant, it's gonna be an extreme of Kill Land. It's other than the Emoji Movie. Because that movie is a piece of monkey poop. So, it's a piece of the Emoji poop. So yeah, stay tuned for that. And my next review, what's my next review anyway? What's gonna be my next review? And I'll probably my next review, I don't really know, because I don't want to wait till my Disney, from the Disney writers on. So yeah, my next rant is none other than the Emoji Movie, and my next review is none other than the Family Guy, so I'm doing my TV show review on Family Guy, so stay tuned for that, and whoever called the Simpson ripoff Family Guy is not the Simpson ripoff, because the Simpson came first and Family Guy came second. So yeah, I'm not a big fan of American Dad. So I'm not watching that. So it's pretty mediocre. And so subscribe, comment, like, share it with your friend. And Freeman, I hope you enjoyed my video. I hope you don't do a commentary of it, because I am trying not to rage. I am very trying to be mature, so. So yeah, stay tuned for my next commentary of Hookery on Inside Being 2001. That's really stupid, so stay tuned for that. And so this is Movie Review, Movie Rant signing off. Alright, see you next time. So long. Peace, you too.
What would I do without you? You'll always have me.